हेलो एवरीबॉडी, ए वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अप टू द हिस्टोलॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ओवरी। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिटेल हिस्टोलॉजी ऑफ ओवरी एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। ओके, सो आफ्टर ओवरी देर आर टू ट्यूब्स व्हिच कनेक्ट व्हिच एक्सटेंड फ्रॉम ओवरी अप टू द यूटेरस। दीज आर कॉल्ड एज ओविडक्ट, ओविडक्ट और फालोपियन ट्यूब्स। ईच ओविडक्ट इज अबाउट 10 टू 12 सेंटीमीटर इन लेंथ। ओके, दीज आर 10 टू 12 सेंटीमीटर इन लेंथ। द ओविडक्ट आर अगेन डिफरेंशिएटेड इनटू फोर पार्ट्स। द प्राइमरी पार्ट व्हिच इज फनेल शेप्ड, इट इज इनफंडिबुलम, इनफंडिबुलम। नेक्स्ट टू इट दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज एम्पुला। नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज इस्थमस एंड द पार्ट व्हिच इज कनेक्टेड विथ यूटेरस इज यूटेराइन पार्ट। ओके, सो दिस आर द डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द ओविडक्ट, फोर डिफरेंट पार्ट। द इनफंडिबुलम इज फनेल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर व्हिच कंसिस्ट ऑफ फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस कॉल्ड एज फिम्ब्राइ, फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन लाइक डिजिट्स ऑफ आर फिंगर, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज फिम्ब्राइ। फॉर द फंक्शन ऑफ फिम्ब्राइ, आफ्टर ओव्यूलेशन द फिम्ब्राइ होल्ड द ओवम लाइक दिस, इट होल्ड द ओवम एंड पुल इट इन टू द ओविडक्ट। ओके, एट द बेस ऑफ फिम्ब्राइ देयर इज एन ओपनिंग कॉल्ड एज ऑस्टियम। Through this ostium, the ovum enter into the next region, ampulla. At the ampullary region, there are some adhesive zones. Okay, at this ampulla of oviduct, some adhesive zones. The zona radiata, at this ampulla, the adhesive zone help in fertilization. That means the ovum is retained here and wait for this spermatozoa for the purpose of fertilization. Okay, so this is ampulla, infundibulum, next ampulla. Then isthmus part, the isthmus, it is the contractile part, isthmus. It help in continuous contraction and relaxation so that it help in propelling spermatozoa towards the ovum for fertilization. Okay, then the uterine part, it help in attachment of oviduct with uterus, it is a connective zone. Okay, so it is all about oviduct. Then there is a sac like structure which is inverted pear shaped structure called as uterus. The uterus is about, this is uterus present in the pelvic cavity which is about 7.6 centimeter in length, 4.5 centimeter in breadth and 3 centimeter in thickness. This is the measurement of uterus. And the adult uterus is about 60 grams in weight in man, particularly in man, it is about 60 grams in weight. Okay, so this is uterus. The uterus is differentiated into three different zones. The upper part is elevated which is called as fundus. Fundus part. The middle part is called as body. The lowest part is cervix. Okay. The cervix is the narrow part. It open into vagina and also open towards uterus. The cervix towards uterus. It consists of internal orifice. Towards vagina, it consists of external orifice. Clear? So this is uterus. The uterus consists of three different layers. What are they? The outermost layer is three different layers. The outermost layer is perimetrium. The middle is myometrium. The inner layer is endometrium. Clear? So the uterus consists of three different layers. Out of this, the endometrium is highly vascular. The blood supply is maximum because it help in formation of placenta. Okay, during development we will read in detail about of these layers. So this is all about uterus. It is inverted pear shape organ. Pear shape, anterior part is wider, the posterior part is narrow, but it's inverted. Okay, then next to uterus, this is vagina. The vagina is the chamber for copulation. Copulation chamber. Okay, this vagina is lined by the inner part of vagina is lined by stratified squamous tissue. Okay, for the function of this stratified squamous tissue, it resists the friction and carries eruga. The irregular thickening of vagina called as eruga. Okay, so this is vagina. Vagina open to outside. This is vaginal orifice. Okay, so this is about the vagina. Next to the external genitalia, so we have discussed oviduct, uterus, then vagina. Then come to the external genitalia of female reproductive system. Then come to the external genitalia. External genitalia of female reproductive system. What are the basic components first? The first part is mons pubis. Okay, except mons pubis, there are mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, clitoris, vestibule, then Bartholin's gland, glands of skin, then forket, then perineum. These are different part of the external genitalia. Let's discuss all these parts in brief. Okay, the external part, this is the external part which is called as vulva. The vulva consists of two folds of skin. There is a outer folding which is labia majora. Labia majora. Below this labia majora, there is another inner folding. This is labia minora. These are devoid of hair. Okay. Devoid of body hair. Above it, there is a layer of fatty tissue. Above labia majora, there is an area which is covered with fatty tissue. This fatty tissue is mons pubis. This area is mons pubis. Pubic hair arises during sexual maturity. Okay. Above this folding, there is pubic hair. Okay. So, this is about mons pubis, labia majora. Labia majora, it is the fleshy fold which extended downward from this, from the front of mons pubis, it is extended downward. Okay. Then, labia minora, inside labia majora, there is inner folding, that is labia minora. Okay. Then the part which is covered by labia minora, this portion is called as vestibule. This portion is called as vestibule. Total area occupied by labia minora is vestibule. Okay. Within the vestibule there are two openings here and here. This opening is a vaginal orifice. This is urethral orifice. Okay, there are two openings, vaginal orifice, urethral orifice. Partially, this vaginal orifice is covered by a thin covering. Cover it, that is called as hymen. It is only found in girls. In women, it has been destroyed. Okay. Then at the junction, upper part, at the junction of labia minora, there is a sensitive organ called as clitoris. Okay. At the junction, this sensitive erectile tiny structure, okay, it is homologous to penis of male due to presence of corpora cavernosa. Okay, so corpora cavernosa, due to its presence, it's homologous to penis. Okay, then Bartholin's gland and glands of skin. Either side of vaginal orifice on its either side, there are Bartholin's gland on either side. At the around urethral orifice, numerous para urethral gland, lesser vestibular gland, these are homologous to prostate gland of male, like a number of glands are, these are glands of skin. Okay. So, these are different type of glands. Okay. It produces lubricating fluid. It lubricates during intercourse. But it produces milky fluid. This gland produces milky fluid with enzymes. It is homologous to prostate gland. Okay. Then at the lower junction of minora, it produces fold. At the labia minora junction, it produces fold. it produces fold. These folds are called as forket. From this forket to anus, a distance lies. Suppose this one is the anus. From forket to anus, this distance is called as perineum. This is called as perineum. Okay. So it is all about the external genitalia of female reproductive system. Okay. So all these parts are associated with different type of functions of female reproductive system. Okay. Thank you all.